Okay. Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining us today. Thank you for attending, and thank you for all good people at FX Street for giving me the opportunity to speak and give my opinion regarding the market, my perspectives of market. I'm very happy to be here, very excited to give you all my ideas and a different perspective of trading. Okay. My name is Telmo Pinto. I'm the founder and director of market operations at intuitiontradinggroup.com. For those who aren't familiar with us, we are a team of professional traders dedicated to provide simple, real-time, and unified trading solutions for investors. Okay. Our aim is to provide consistent and profitable return to investors, irrespective of the climate, okay, economic climate. So you aren't in the money, your Forex daily commentary here exclusive at fxstreet.com. It's important to give this disclaimer, okay? Important to read because we are here I'm here to give my opinion regarding the markets, but any of these opinions is any recommendation for buy, sell, or everything. If you need, if you do your own trading, please seek advice for independent financial advisor. Arley, I'm from Portugal. We are reserving like 5 minutes at the end of the webinar regarding your questions regarding what we are going to show. Okay. So let's start. Regarding our trading, we use a proprietary trading system. Okay, we developed the software special for our trading group. We don't look for any price or time price, okay, base bars. The best description to show you is using a Renko chart. For those who are not familiar with them, is a type of chart developed by the Japanese that is only concerned with the price movement, okay? Time and volume are not included on the chart, okay? Sorry, okay. Like I was told, we mostly use rankers to give our entry signals, okay? Use some additional indicators like market sentiment that I'm going to show you later. And we prefer this because this completely reduces the noise of the trading, okay? If you use time charts, there is plenty of noise. For instance, this is a EURUSD chart since 2 of August. We use mostly 21 pips, 34 pips, or 55 pips on the Renko, okay? No, no, is Renko, Arley, like I was told him, okay? We can use three different time periods, okay, or it's not time, but range periods in the bars. We can use 21 pips, 34 pips, or 55 pips, okay? And we use them regarding the market volatility. Sometimes you can use the 21 pips like I'm showing you now in the EURUSD due to lack of volatility, okay? It's August, we have some good volatility at the beginning because of the FOMC meeting, okay, and the NFP, the report. But after that, the market entering in range, okay, then break again, but I will explain it. For instance, on the EPUSD, for instance, this is a 34 pips chart, okay, Renko bars. because the GBP is a pair more range pair, not trending. Okay, but let's begin with Euro USD. Okay, we really prefer the Renko charts because you can see clearly the support and the breaks in the market. For instance, here we can see the market is supporting at this level. Okay. And probably making here a triangle. Okay. This is from last week. Okay. This began 22 August. Came down, up, down. Yesterday, it opens here. Now it's climbing again. Okay. What we can expect from here? We have the previous lower, higher low here. Okay. So what we can expect for market from here? We can expect or a break above this line, okay? And we can enter by this, okay, 125, 50 area, 125, 60 area, okay? Or we can expect a break of this level. And in a break of this level, we surely can expect a come to the 124, 50 area, okay? Is like two bars and testing the previous higher low of the market. Okay, so this is mainly the situation in the euro now. We have an important meeting 6 September that will decide the euro area. Okay, and this meeting can create a huge bubble on the euro. This last step move on the euro, I think, is the market creating this bubble already, okay? Is expecting that the ECB change the rates and with that, easier money, okay? But on the other side, this can create a huge bubble and we can go south heavily, okay? So mainly the situation of the euro to resume is expecting a break of this level can bring us at least to 124.50 area, 124.30 area, okay? To this area, testing this latest higher low. If break upside, we can go to the 126 area that came from June hikes, okay? Sorry. Okay. One twenty-six area, more or less. Billy. Well, the stops is defined by the weekly volatility. Okay. Like I explained earlier, we use the 21 pips, the 34 pips, and the 55 pips. Okay. You can see sometimes a confluence area in the three charts, okay? If you can put the three charts sometimes. Sorry. But the mainly the stop we use are about 60 pips to 80 pips, okay? Is about 2-3 bars of our current chart. For instance, this is a 21 pip chart. We use maximum 2-3 bars, okay? Or sometimes we can look at confluence areas. For instance, this is a confluence area, okay? If you can see here, the market break this previous hike. Okay, let me show. Okay. If you look here, let's put this way so you can see better, okay? Here the market was ranging, testing the previous, make higher low. Okay, make another higher low, make another higher low, break this area, this heavy resistance here, okay, go and test the other resistance, break and come to test. This happens about 80-90% of the times, okay, when market break, it comes and tests the previous break, okay. And then go up again, and now in this area, okay? If you're thinking, for instance, to give a quick example, if you're thinking in enter, in this break, okay, you can put the stop above this area, okay? If you want to enter in here, okay, you can put the stop this area, 125.50 area, okay? Is the best thing because market can go down, then test this area, 125.20 area, okay? And then went down. Okay? No, the stops are based on the weekly volatility, okay, really. But we mostly use 2, 3 bars, as I told you, okay? We mostly use that because on Renko, okay, the basics of Renko is entering when you have 2 contrary bars. That is the basics, okay? But what happen if you use the two breaks? You can have very confluent series and give a lot of false enters. Let me show you an example, for instance, this example, okay? In these areas, the purist, okay, of the Renko should have entered short here, long here, and then short again. But in order you to protect your orders here, okay, you can enter short here, okay, and only enter long, okay, or put your stop above the last stop, okay? This is the best option you can use when trading Renko charts. Expect a break or the previous high or the previous low in order market go up and break or go down and break, okay? So the situation in euro, sorry, is this: market is making lower highs, okay? We can see if market break up, okay, or if break down. At least this support 124.90 area, 125, is holding the market now, okay? A break and come to 124.75 area can bring us further down, okay? Okay, Billy, regarding our money management, this is our that is our key, okay, to our trading. We use a proprietary money management that give us the advantage to trade on the Renko chart, okay? The time frame, Bookie, depends because we don't use time and the normal time, okay? We use a pip range, okay? As I told you, the EURUSD is a 21, like I'm showing you, but we mostly use 21 pips, 34 pips, or 55 pips, okay? Depends on the volatility of the market. Okay, now let's see the situation on the OC pair, okay? On the OC pair was curious because last week we had several tries to break this area, okay? We have several times to break this area. If you see, like I explained earlier on the error, market come down, okay, make higher low. It's very important you to see the higher lows or lower highs on the chart, okay? With that, you can define already more most likely the trend of the pair. If you see here, since 11 July, 11 June, sorry, you have here the bottom, okay? Market go up, higher low, make another higher low, okay? This you can understand like a lower high, okay? But if you are a strong uptrend, like you see here, this is already 300 pips, okay? You can expect testing, make another high, okay? Go down. This is what we call a two steps retracement, okay? Come down, up, down, make another higher low of the pair, break the high, making a higher low, break the high, and in this area, market was already losing a lot of momentum, okay? Make here, go test the level, go test the level, 104 level, okay? And this is almost 1 month trading, okay? As you can see, the OC was clearly making a top, okay? So what we can expect now on the OC pair is probably coming to the 102.50 area, okay? This area, okay? Making here more 2 or 3, 34 pips bar, okay? Because the congestion area was very high, okay? They came 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 tests to this area, okay? And the last one was very narrow, the range. If you see here, this is a range of about 100 pips, okay? And this is the area we have to take care of most of our money. Why? Because we can show the market in range and we can trade that range, okay? But when it breaks, we can lose all the money we make on the range and plus, okay? So it's very important you take care of these areas, okay? When you see this confluence, this is most likely when the pair is ready to break, okay? No, this is live charts, okay? Market, this is live charts now, okay? So in the OC pair, like I told you, we can expect the pair go down to 102.50 area, more or less, okay? This area. Can go test here, but this is, okay, depends on the momentum of the market, okay? On the GBP, okay, on the British pound, we have this congestion area, congestion area, congestion area, and then no, is the offline? Okay. Sorry, let me explain. Okay, like you know, the MT4 only used the periods, like for instance, okay, you can have 1 minute, 5, okay, 4 hours, daily, weekly. We can create these Renko charts, a script that like I can provide you, okay, and I can provide you all if you want to follow, okay, but it's a free script, and what we have is emulate, okay, the Renko charts there, because the MT4 platform are not able to create Renko bars as it is, okay? We only can provide time charts bar and defined by the M1, M5, M15, 30 minutes, 1 hour, etc., okay? That's why it appears there offline, but the market is trading now, okay? So this is real charts, okay? So let's continue. Okay, Boyki, let's resume here a bit. Renko charts are not defined by time, okay? Let me explain. Renko charts are not defined by time, okay? This is not time bars. This is range bars, okay? In this example, the GBP is 34 pips range, okay? To make one bar, okay, is needed a pair go up, in this case, the pair go up 34 pips, okay? This is 34 pips of the market, okay? So, in order you have this bar down, market need to go down 68 pips down, okay? Because we have 34 for this and more 34. These 34 pips or 68 pips can be in 1 day, in 1 minute, or in 1 week, okay? That's why I told in the beginning that we trade with 21 pips, 34 pips, or 55 pips, depending on the market volatility. Okay? So this spike, what happened is market go up, didn't close the bar. This is from this up, didn't make another 34 pips, okay? And then come down, and this bar is almost or is already more than 100 pips. This is more than 100 pips, okay? Because you have almost 34 pips here, more 34 pips here, and 34 pips here. So this is about, is more than 100 pips, okay? So, well, why do I choose 24, 21, 34, 55? Good question. It's based on Fibonacci numbers, okay? I don't trade based on Fibonacci. I only trade based on price action. This is pure price action, okay? I don't use any indicators. I only use Eiger lows, like I was explaining to you, and trend lines to see the trend line of the market, okay? So it's not guessed. It's, okay, but it's based on the study we have made based on the cycle of the pairs, okay? We have seen that 21, 34, and 55 are very good ranges on the pairs, okay? And based on the weekly volatility, we use those numbers to create our charts, okay? For instance, if you go back to 2008 or 2009, a 34 pips range is completely ridiculous to use because we had days that, for instance, the British pounds move 300 pips. So in that time, for sure, we use only the 55 pips. On today's market, we mostly use 21 pips or 34 pips for our trading, okay? The 55 we can use to see the higher time frames. Like, for instance, a one-hour trader can look at the daily or the weekly to see the more eager perspective of the market, okay? So we choose based on the weekly volatility, okay? And what we are going to see. Okay, so regarding the British pound, what we have here, we have not a very solid up move here because the market was not straight up, okay? This is a lot of congestion areas, okay? So this pair, I really prefer to see clear this area, okay? Clear, in order to enter short, I really prefer to see clear this area because if market goes down, this is very confluence area, okay, in order the pair to trade here. And the pair can go down and enter here and stay here in the range of about 100 pips, okay? This is about 140 pips, so the pair can stay here, okay? If the market decided to go up, okay, we have these levels here, this level here, mainly our first test, okay? Here was the previous test from this breaks, okay? Break, test, okay? We have here a break, a test. If the market go up, for sure, it will need to test the 155, 50, or 20 area, and then we can see in up moves. On the downside, it's very complicated because this is very tough areas for market to break, okay? This is very complicated area, okay? So, euro, okay. We'll see now the Swiss, okay? The Swiss pair. As you know, the Swiss pair is almost exactly the opposite of the euro pair. If euro pair go up, the Swiss franc go down. Okay. Although on the Renko, we can see many differences. Okay, in the market. For instance, here we have a clearly downtrend. Here we have a clearly uptrend. Okay. For now, the levels you are seeing here, mostly, for sure, this is a short move, okay? This is a short move for market go down, okay? we can think in entry long or in the break only above this area, okay? 96, 50 is the area we are looking for possible long moves, okay? Because this is the mainly level, okay? This breaks up, 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 and now testing this level. So this is key level on the Swiss franc is the 96.50 area, okay? You can see this like the horizontal line, okay? If break up, we can see in more of moves. For down, we are only thinking shorts, okay? Because this is the, as you can see here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, four tops, and now 1, 2, 3 tests, okay? Okay, so to finish here regarding the Japanese yen, okay, is in very tough area, okay? Is a complicated pair, the Japanese yen, because it is not so trendy pair, but the levels you are seeing now is this area, okay, here, okay, and this area here, okay? So this is the key areas for the Japanese yen, 78 or 79 to be more precise, okay? Or on the downside, a really break on the 78 area, okay? So this is the level. Okay, the two flies. Okay, so today this was the introduction, so you can see how we trade, okay, the Renko bars, the how we made our trades, okay. Tomorrow we'll explain a little bit with more examples, okay. If anyone can or wants the Renko script to use and to see the trading, please you can contact us in order to make questions, okay? You can contact us to so I can give you the scripts, okay? So if you have any other questions, thank you very much for attending. I know this is a lot of information soon, but tomorrow we'll have another webinar, and with the time, for sure, we're going to develop here a good work, okay, to understand a completely different method of trading based only on the Renko chart. Sorry to be so quickly, but okay. Thank you very much for attending, and I hope to see you all tomorrow, okay? Thank you.